try and read my lyrics off of this paper before.
Thanks so much for tuning into the NBA here on 2K Sports. Welcome to Wednesday night here in the NBA. It's the Boston Celtics going up against the Brooklyn Nets. And that'll do it from the studio. Let's get you out to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports broadcast crew at the arena. I'll see you back here at halftime.
We make it cool to be suck.
Welcome to 2K Sports for another edition of NBA Basketball. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. Doris Burke will be reporting from the sidelines. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. And as we take a look here at Kevin Garnett, guys, what's your take?
Well, the biggest thing with Kevin Garnett is the impact he has on the game at the defensive end of the floor. He covers so much space. He's got those long arms. He's a wonderful communicator, kind of the quarterback of that defense. And he will shut down the player he's guarding on a nightly basis.
You know, it isn't just on defense that KG is a quiet influence. When he's on O, even if he's not scoring, he's drawing attention, creating space for his teammates, and then finding them for easy baskets. You just don't find post players like him very often. He's a once-in-a-generation kind of player.
The Nets will look to their home court advantage. Just one game here in Brooklyn. This, of course, being game one of the season, is their first look at the Celtics.
In a season ago, Clark, they won the matchup, winning three and losing just one.
Yeah, I think they're a little better than this ball club, and it showed last year winning the season series.
Tries from seven, and too long on the shot. On defense, Brooklyn. Olynyk sets a screen for Bradley. Rondo passes to Bass. Outside, Green. Shot clock at five. Outside, Bradley. Let's it go with the three. And it's Johnson with the rebound. Steve just mentioned how they won the season series a year ago. That was the way it went against most teams they faced.
True. They were a very hard team to get the best of, Kevin.
Now here's Johnson, averaging 16 points a game. Off target with the... look. And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. Bradley kicks to Rondo. Rondo off the pick from Bass. And it's Rondo penetrating. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
You know, last season, Doc Rivers said he was hoping for Rajon Rondo to be even more aggressive and assertive than usual. The Celtics are at their best when Rondo looks to score first and then distribute later.
Well, going back to Rondo last season, he did up his scoring about 2 points a game, Clark, to I think about 14 a game.
And you factor in 11 assists a game as well, Kevin. So never a guy who's going to lead the league in scoring, but a nightly double-double machine. And on occasion, he'll throw that triple-double at you, too.
Now here's Williams, averaging 19 points per contest. That is good. And the Celtics with possession here. Rondo kicks to Bradley. Green, Pierce covering. And Green gets it to go.
Even with the D lurking, he made it look easy with the soft finger roll. You know, a big part of why the Celtics dropped so much last season was they weren't very good on the road. Ended with a 14-27 record away from home, which was by far the lowest of any team in the East that made the playoffs.
Now here's Pierce. No good from outside. Got the defender off his feet with the pump fake, but couldn't knock it down. Here's Bradley. It's blocked. They recover it. Outside Rondo. Pass with a screen for Rondo. Tries again. The shot is off. And Brooklyn will now go the other way with it. And as you said, Clark, rarely can you win just over a third of your road games like the Celtics did and expect to make the playoffs. And had they played closer to 500 on the road. Now, Steve, there's a good chance they could have ended up as the fifth or the fourth seed.
Well, and in the Celtics' case, it wasn't their defense, Kevin. It was their offense that betrayed them when they went out onto the road. They just couldn't win the close games. And some of it was just age and injury. But so many of those road losses from last year just came back to haunt them, and that's why they ended up with that 7 seed.
Brooklyn trailing. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
I had a chance to talk with the head coach for Brooklyn. He said their main focus will be trying to contain Rajon Rondo. He said, quote, "We all know that Rondo's capable of taking over games single-handedly. So, guys," he said, "they've got to match his energy and try to keep him out of the paint."
Thank you, Doris.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot. Woo! Kicking it out!
And here is Olynyk. Here's Bradley. Jump shot is good that time. 1:35 left to play here in the first. On the wing, Williams. He's covered by Rondo. Here's Lopez. Another one falls for Brooklyn. So the Celtics called timeout. They're first.
You know, the new home for the Nets last season, as they moved over from New Jersey to Brooklyn, and they must have loved their new digs because they were fantastic in front of this Brooklyn crowd last season. 26-15 here.
Clark, you're right. The Nets are making a good impression here, as you were saying. Always good for a team to open up a new arena with a strong record at home.
And what a great stadium, guys. At Barclays Center, one of the best-looking floors in the NBA. Great design all around. And even on the outside, when you walk up to the arena here in Brooklyn, it's just a beautiful atmosphere.
Celtics making a switch here. Jared Sullinger's checked in for Olynyk. Humphries comes in for Brandon Bass. Gerald Wallace, he's checked in for Jeff Green. And it's Lee in for Avery Bradley. That's good.
Perseverance paying off on the offensive boards, guys.
Nets have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Williams kicks to Johnson. Back to Williams. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Lopez backs in. And he tries off the glass, but it's no good. 2-for-1 chance here.
Yeah, let's see if they use the clock to their advantage.
Here's Rondo, averaging 14 points a game. And it's Lee penetrating. Here's the teardrop.
Way to play in it. Get inside.
And you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
The Celtics shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. And the first one drops. So for the Nets, Blotch comes in for Brook Lopez. And Kirilenko's subbed in for Kevin Garnett. Good on the second, so he makes them both.
He's always been extremely reliable at the line, and today's been no different.
Outside Williams. Humphries gets the rebound. Now here's Lee, averaging 8 points a game. Back to Rondo. With one on the clock, Williams with the block. And so the first quarter is in the books. Boston on top, leading by 4. And the second quarter will be on the way when we come back.
Coming up next Monday, October 6th.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And the Celtics, guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
Man, it's really been a dominant effort on the glass. That's been the key here.
Yeah, they've established nice low post presence, which always tends to help you on the rebounding battle. You know, one part of Joe Johnson's game that tends to get overlooked, guys, is his ability to create space with the dribble. He's got great size, and that ability makes him the potent scorer he is.
On the court for the Celtics, second quarter underway.
The guards, Rajon Rondo and Courtney Lee. Wallace out there with Humphries. And it's Sellinger in at the five, roaming the paint. And for Joe Johnson, as you mentioned, Clark, great size. And he's comfortable, truly, Steve, from shooting anywhere on the floor.
Yeah, and whether it's a spot up or off the dribble, he can go either direction. He's so strong, excellent ball handling ability. But I think he could do a little more damage inside if he chose to. He's got the body to be a good post-up player.
Now let's send it to Doris from the sideline.
Well, guys, for Jason Kidd, who has taken over as head coach of the Nets with no coaching experience, certainly there's some apprehension about how he'll do. But one thing we are certain of, he knows how to lead. On Team USA, the coaching staff raved about Kidd's leadership in winning the gold in 2008. Former Knicks teammate Raymond Felton summed it up this way, saying, quote, he's a great role model, a father figure who understands the game, understands life. I think he'll be a great coach. The guys will listen to him. Kevin?
I like his chances. Thanks. Back to Williams. Feeds to Johnson. Six on the shot clock. From outside, off the mark.
They were the new kid in town with all new uniforms and a new arena last season, but the Brooklyn Nets actually played at a very deliberate pace. Part of their success playing at that pace had to do with the fact that they took good care of the ball.
Sellinger dishes to Lee. And out of bounds as the Nets gain possession.
Let's take a moment here to see some of the numbers for Deron Williams. Fifth in assists, 12th in free throw percentage. And he's in the top 15 in points per game. So he's a guy you have to account for defensively.
And, you know, we'd be remiss not to say a word about his outstanding assist ranking. Come on now. I mean, this guy is one of the top assist men in the game and doing it with flair and fundamental soundness. That's special.
And if you saw the roster, it makes complete sense for this Brooklyn team. They have guys that can get out and run, but they also have a group, Steve, that has big bodies and knows how to create offense in the half court.
Well, when you see that kind of balance offensively, great point guard play, a center who can score, then you get the help that they were able to put together in the offseason with Garnett, Pierce, Kirilenko, Jason Terry. I mean, this is a team that really has a lot of pieces.
Here's Kirilenko. And again, it's the Nets missing.
Hard work on the glass once again, fellas. They put a lot of effort into their rebound.
Well, you get more rebounds, you get more possessions, more shots at the hoop, and oftentimes that decides the game.
Sellinger with a screen for Rondo. Pass to Sellinger. Rondo kicks to Sellinger. That's good. Sellinger's got his first points of the night.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
Williams. And again, no good by Brooklyn.
You know, Deron Williams suffered a lot of injuries in the first half of last season and finally got healthy in the second half, and it showed. He was fantastic during the last 30 or 40 games or so. And I think now with all this talent around him, the situation is perfect for Williams to reestablish himself as one of the elite players in this league.
Nets trail by 10. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Kirilenko, the pass to Pierce. Dishes to Blotch. Humphries there. Outside Williams. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Trying to get back on track. An absolute bomb from three-point range. Williams has got 5 points so far. And for Williams last season, he seemed to get better, Clark, as the season wore on. Not usually the case with injuries.
But I think he, like a lot of players, Kevin, may have still been recovering from the grind of the condensed schedule. Seasons ago, you know, he started playing in Turkey before starting that tough shortened season. So you factor in Team USA play in the summer, he put a lot of wear and tear on his body, and I think it just took a while for it to rebound.
Olenek, he's checked in for the Celtics.
Here's Rondo. He's got eight. Kicks to Bass. Outside, Green.
Rondo.
Green gets a screen from Bass. Five to shoot. Knocks it loose. Taken away by Kirilenko. Pass to Johnson. Throws it down as the official calls the foul. It may be a three-point play. It's on Rajon Rondo.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
It feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close. You look at the Joe Johnson trade for the Nets. They picked up his max contract from the Hawks, committing $80 million over 4 years. But, you know, last season, his lowest point output in over a decade, a down season overall. But, hey, there's a lot of talent on this team. He's not expected to score as much anymore.
Rondo dishes to Olynyk. Outside, Brantley. He passes to Rondo. Shot, high post. Rebound, Blatch. Nets trailed by four.
And if they're smart, they will hold for the last shot.
That's got to be the objective here, Steve.
And it's Johnson again missing. And here we go with Avery Bradley. Outside, Rondo. Three-pointer. He got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And we're through two here and a good one. Celtics lead by four. 2K Sports back in a moment here in Brooklyn.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
It's Hump Day, and this is 2K Sports.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And as we return, the view here of the landmark Statue of Liberty, illuminating this beautiful night. Rajon Rondo with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He has that slasher mentality, guys, and we saw all the evidence of that in the first half as he continually got to the rim and scored.
Yeah, he had the jetpack on today, Steve, blowing by the defender no matter who they put on him. Well, you know, last season I think officially brought the immediate championship aspirations of the Celtics to a close. The seventh seed in the East, dispatched in the first round by the Knicks, the rebuild was on in full cycle.
Jaren Williams and Joe Johnson at the one and two. Watch out there with Andre Kirilenko. And it's Lopez in at the five down low. So that's the Nets five. The open shot by Johnson. Gets an open look and hits. Of the third quarter up on the board for the Nets. And back to the Celtics, making the playoffs, sure, but, you know, not like Steve back in 08 or 2010.
Well, this has been a phenomenal era, you know, with KG and Pierce that is now a thing of the past. But look, they've hoisted a championship banner very close to another, but it's just time to move on. And that's just the way it is in the NBA. These things go in waves, and the Celtics now in rebuilding mode.
Here's Kirilenko. Chance there to take the lead, missing. The Celtics with the lead. They'll be playing host to Toronto for the next one. That'll be the first of two straight at home. And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Gentlemen, Andre Kirilenko declined a second-year player option on his contract with the Timberwolves worth $10 million. He had to settle for a lot less in Brooklyn, but at least a chance to play for a stacked team looking to contend for a title. Kevin?
Well, they've definitely added some quality size, Doris. No question about that. We'll see how they do.
Well, head coach Jason Kidd, that's a phrase I didn't expect to hear this quickly, but Kidd wasted no time. Only a matter of weeks after he announced his retirement as a player, he was named the head coach of the Brooklyn Nets. And it's going to be interesting to see the transition. Kidd, obviously, great basketball IQ, so well respected as a person in the league. I think it's just a matter of time before he really finds his footing and becomes an excellent coach.
Passes shot, good. And it's a 7-point Celtic lead. The Nets shooting the ball at 42%. Tries it from 19. And the Nets miss again. And back to Coach Jason Kidd-Clark, a rookie at the coaching profession, but one of the most intelligent, respected point guards over his 19 years in the NBA.
Yeah, always respected as a leader, and his basketball IQ off the chart. So I think he's one of the few guys that could go right from playing to being a successful head coach.
Here's Rondo. With the clock winding down and finished off by Bass.
Well, he won that battle, and in general, they're winning most of the battles tonight.
Well, those are some very easy points if you can get them.
Well, and like Clark said, they have been getting them, not necessarily all on putback dunks, but a lot of second-chance opportunities.
To end the run, and Lopez with the nice bucket inside. Lopez has got his second basket.
Boy, he can be a matchup nightmare inside the paint.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
You knew that at some point the window for the group of Celtics that had won a title was going to close. I mean, it was inevitable. But last year it seemed like they were going to go for one last hurrah as they added some depth and looked to reload for another run.
Kevin Garnett has checked in for the Nets. Terry comes in for Andre Kirilenko. 1:43 left in the third quarter. Rondo kicks to Bradley. Left side, Bradley. It's stolen by Johnson. Oh, and here comes Johnson all alone. Goes straight to the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line. It's on Rajon Rondo.
Terrible transition defense there.
I think it would have been pointless, Steve. There was no way anybody was beating him to the basket there.
That's good from Johnson. And getting back to the Celtics and Rondo's injury, a lot of people expected them to start the rebuilding process. Ended up standing pat at the deadline, Steve, even though there was, it seemed, a lot of interest.
You know, you want to give that group, KG and Pierce and Rondo, you want to give them another run. And they had their last hurrah. They didn't get it finished. And now you start the rebuilding project. So a lot of trades, a lot of movement over the summer. But I like the fact that they gave that club one more run.
Here's where Boston sits right now, Kevin, in the current league ranking. Sixth in shooting percentage. Sixth in free throw percentage. And they're in the top half of the league in getting steals as well. Not bad, but could be better.
And they've shot the ball pretty well. You talked about that field goal percentage. And I think it just shows that they're playing well together, they're playing hard, and they're playing well at both ends of the floor. Because in order to have a good field goal percentage, you have to play good defense as well.
Racking up the points down low, well, that's exactly what these guys have done this season. Check out the top scoring big men in the NBA. Brook Lopez is second.
And there are different styles among those big men, but they have one thing very much in common. They can dominate offensively, face up or back to the basket. They can get it done.
And that's what makes that list so intriguing to me, Steve, just how varied it is in terms of technique each of those big men use. I mean, you could fill a textbook by taking a little piece of each of their games. I mean, they all do something different and unique and do it well.
6 second difference between shot and game clock. Terry, the good looking shot from the wing. The Celtics have gone 3 of 8 so far in the third quarter, looking to lock in that rhythm. Rondo kicks to Bradley. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. Boston shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here. Free throw good from Bradley. The Celtics making a switch here. And so he makes both from the line. 8 seconds left here in the third quarter. Terry outside. Got it to go with no time left on the clock.
You talk about stepping up at a big moment. That is some fortitude, folks.
I should say.
The awareness, the release, everything was just perfect.
We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. It's the Celtics leading by just one. And do not go away, as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our fourth quarter coming up next.
NBA
preseason action.
Welcome back, everyone. We're ready to get going again as this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports continues. Players are topped off with Gatorade, hydrated, and ready to get going again as well. And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Celtics?
They've been the aggressors, and they've been tougher in the paint all game.
You know, they've also been very good from the free throw line. I mean, that's been a very important part of what they've done today.
Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. On the court right now for the Celtics, Avery Bradley is out there with Lee. Then it's Wallace. Then it's Jared Sollinger. And it's Humphreys in the power forward. Wallace, the pass to Bradley. Humphreys. And he drops it in from the low post. And the Celtics lead by one. Williams kicks to Terry. He dishes it to Garnett. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Well, they were sleeping on defense. The defense really didn't do its job. I mean, a little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint, that's costly.
Well, and at this stage of such a tight game, I think this is when tired legs start to show. And the defense can become vulnerable in the low block.
Jeff Green, he's checked in for the Celtics. Rondo comes in for Courtney Lee. The free throw drops for Garnett.
A big change for the Nets, who stormed up the leaderboard in the East and even had a chance at taking a very tough Atlantic division last season. They actually were in the picture for the title until the end.
Moment now to see how the schedule is looking for Brooklyn. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Washington, where they'll face the Wizards. That'll be just one game played away from home for them.
Yeah, a lot of fans focused on that matchup for Detroit.
Ball is with a screen on Terry. The drive by Rondo. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. And the Nets' first goal going forward this year is to make that jump into the best team in New York and the rest of the division. Steve, a lot of strong teams in the Atlantic, but they do well against them.
Yeah, last year they had the best interdivision record than anybody in the Atlantic. So, you know, if you can take care of business within your division, it always puts you in a good position down the stretch.
Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. Williams against Rondo. Williams dishes to Garnett. The kick out to Williams. The feed to Johnson. Lock at six. Lopez backs in. The Nets need to get a shot off here. And the shot is good from Johnson.
You know, it seems like when they've gone to him, he's really come through. And that's not something they should get away from.
Rondo passes to Green. Back to Rondo. He feeds it to Bradley. Rondo. This ball movement by Boston. Wallace kicks to Rondo. Shoots. Rebound, Brooklyn. Johnson's got three rebounds so far in the game. Outside, Williams. Back to Terry. Left side, Williams. Let's it go. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. Now it's a four-point Nets lead.
And what I like about him, he needs very little time to get his shot off. If he has just a bit of room, that's all it takes. In a catch-and-shoot situation, he's going to let it fly.
You know, something else with him, you can't forget about his skill as a pull-up shooter. I mean, you give him too much room, and he won't hesitate for a second to raise up and spray you with that J.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Kevin, the head coach for the Celtics, had some instruction for his guys during that break. He told his guys, "I know we can do this, fellas. Let's maximize every possession and get after it. And just watch. Things will go our way." Kevin?
Here's Humphreys. Cannot hit. Good D by Lopez. Nets leading by four. Williams dishes to Johnson. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up. And that's now 19 points for Joe Johnson.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
Yeah, they have the defense on the run right now because every pass seems to have a purpose. They're getting great movement, great spacing, and they're really lining them up defensively.
Deflects the pass. Humphreys with the steal. Rondo passes to Olynyk. Back to Rondo. Now the dish to Humphreys. Green. They need this. Kevin Garnett grabs the miss. Garnett's got his third rebound tonight. Johnson kicks to Williams. From deep. Rebound by Jeff Green. Green's got three rebounds so far in the game. Rondo with it. Now Garnett defending. That's good. And that's now 6 points for Avery Bradley.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Williams dishes to Terry. Passes it to Lopez. Defended by Olynyk. From six away. Cannot hit. Nice, Steve.
He operates pretty well in traffic, guys, but that was a tough play to finish off.
Into Green. Count it! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
Boy, he quieted the crowd with that big shot. That's a big play.
Yeah, the crowd's been hoping for something to cheer for, but nothing.
Terry kicks to Johnson. And the pass to Lopez. Defended by Olynyk. Post-up shot. That's short off the rim. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. He kicks it to Green. And out of bounds as Brooklyn gains possession. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Smart foul there. You've got to try to extend the game.
Yeah, it's still close, but they're fighting that clock as much as the score right now.
Humphreys with the steal.
And a chance here to send it into overtime.
Need a three.
Outside, Green. The three won't fall. And he commits the intentional foul. He drops the first one, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. Second one is good. We both at the line, and it's a 5-point game.
And you got to think those free throws are the nail in the coffin, guys.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They trail by 5. 3 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, what do you think?
Well, this one's out of reach, so I'm not sure why they're calling the timeout here. Maybe just to try to work on something, maybe an out-of-bounds play or something.
Well, they might as well talk about what movies they want to see or what they want to surf on the Internet, because this one's done, boys.
And so it's Brooklyn with the win. They pulled off this win, Clark, with respect.